Welcome to Ecoholics. In this lecture, we will discuss about comparative advantage theory. Now, this theory is an extension after the Adam Smith's absolute advantage. So if you have not seen that lecture, you can see that lecture and the link given in the description of this video. So after that video, come on to this particular video. Now here in comparative advantage theory, this theory was given by David Ricardo. Now this theory, if you remember the last theory, absolute advantage theory, in the absolute advantage theory, there was a saying that if a country is having the absolute advantage, then only they can engage in the trade. But what Ricardo said that if a country is not having the absolute advantage in both the commodities, then also can there is a possibility for the international trade. So this is how we will see that if a country is not having the absolute advantage in both the commodities, then also the trade can be favorable. So here with the help of the example, we'll see that how David Ricardo performed that particular notion. On the same lines, we'll take suppose India and China, two countries. These are hypothetical figures. So suppose we'll take wheat and we'll take rice. On the both side, we can say, suppose this is 6, this is 1, this is 3, this is 2. So this is kg per labor hours. And this is also kg per labor hours. Simple enough, I'll explain what is this. It means in one labor hour, India can produce 6 kg of wheat. In one labor hour, India can produce 6 kg of wheat. On the same lines, China can produce only 1. On the same lines, 3 for rice and 2 for China, that is for rice. Now here in this particular picture, in this particular numbers, it is clearly visible that India is having the absolute advantage in both the commodities, in wheat as well as in rice. It means India can produce wheat and rice more efficiently than China. So it means China is having absolute disadvantage in both the commodities. Again, I'm saying these are hypothetical figures. So just for the sake of example, now how we can analyze that what India will produce or what China will produce. Like in this example, we take that we have to see where the absolute disadvantage for China is less. Like for example, if we see 6:1 and 3:2. So it is clearly visible that the absolute disadvantage is less in terms of rice for China. So what we'll say, India will produce wheat and China will produce rice. This is how we can figure out this particular trade. Now forget about this. Now suppose that India is trying to engage in the trade. Like for example, India is producing 6W and they are exchanging for 6R. Here we can say that it means India will produce 6 kg of wheat and they will exchange this 6 kg of wheat with 6 kg of rice produced by China. Now what happened if we see that India is now getting 3R extra. Why 3R extra? Because India can produce 3R domestically, but because with the help of international trade, they are getting 3 more kg of rice. So here India is getting 3R just because of the international trade. Suppose for example, if China was not actually engaging in the trade with India and was not importing 6W from India, what happened? It means China would have been producing 6W at their domestic economy. So what happened for that? It means they were able to devote this 6 working hours of labor to wheat so that after the international trade, they can devote 6 labor hours to rice. It means 2 × 6 labor hours. So they are able to produce 12R. This is how we can trade after international trade. What will happen? India will gain 6W in place of 6R. So India will gain 3R. So that is 3R India will gain. What about China? China is producing 12R. They are giving 6 hours to India. Remaining 6 hours is their advantage. So after international trade, what is happening? That India is getting 3 hours extra. And what China is getting? China is getting 6 hours remaining from this production, as well as 6W from India. This is how we can say about this particular complex situation. So I hope you understand this lecture. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment box as well as on the numbers given in the description of this video. This is my WhatsApp number. You can directly contact with me. I hope you find it very useful. Please like the video, share with your colleagues, friends, and do comment in the comment box, because it takes a lot to make lectures like these. It's a late night, it's 2 a.m. So you can understand the amount of effort and hard work. So whenever you are commenting, it's like a reward for us. So do comment, and please don't forget to subscribe Ecoholics, as well as click on the bell icon. And apart from this, we are also having the mobile app, where we are providing courses for undergraduate, postgraduate economics, as well as some competitive examinations like UGC NET Economics, Indian Economic Services, Economics Optional for Mains, UPSC, IAS, Econometrics, Mathematical Economics, various other things. So for that, visit ecoholics.in. Have a nice day. Thank you so much.